So I lost my first biological child, Finley, at 35 weeks in 2022. He was stillborn. And following that, I got pregnant quite quickly with my son, Miles. And pregnancy after loss is its own unique, horrifying beast in itself emotionally, but logistically and medically, it's like a full-time job. And so whilst being at the same time, you know, I was pregnant and I needed sick days to be pregnant, I was also having to juggle, you know, going to medical appointments once, like at minimum twice a week, you know, and having to go to those appointments alone often as well, because my husband was unable to take leave. And so when your only experience of pregnancy and birth is death, that's what you come to expect. And so I was going into a lot of these appointments with a lot of fear and anxiety and stress and isolation, because my husband was unable to take the time off work to come with me. It's just a simple fact. And by putting these words out there, it makes it a little bit more normal. It makes it easier to talk about. It makes it easier for other people to sort of understand what you're going through. It would have made it significantly less stressful. You know, I'd spent most of Miles's pregnancy thinking about what's going to happen if this baby dies, and I didn't need to having to be considering paid leave and if we were able to afford both parents taking time off work to go to these appointments. So I think it would have taken so much of the stress and anxiety out of that whole experience, where it was already a stressful and upsetting experience. But I think having the reproductive leave would have made it easier on myself.